Hi, Scott here from Outlaw Garage. This is the big money special. The first 2 years of ownership with a 930. Let's crack on with the video and see how much we spent. So key things to remember here when you have an old classic Porsche, you import it into a new country, it comes into a new climate and environment, that the car has to adapt to that environment, the heat, the humidity, what was probably okay in one country might not be okay in this country, and the car does kind of change and adapt as a person would do to the environment that it's in. So with that being said, we'll crack on with the details and the paperwork that we've got here for the first year of ownership. Now, the first challenge that we had with the car was that when we went to get it out the sea container, the battery was actually flat. The reason for this was that the car had been fitted with an aftermarket immobilizer, and the immobilizer had actually been switched on while it was in the sea container. You can imagine the immobilizer being on while the car's in the sea container. It's rocking around on the boat. The alarm must have been going off. The immobilizer must have been on pretty much straight away as soon as the sea container got loaded onto the boat. And that made the battery go flat. Next issues that we experienced were that we were out one night, we were driving the car, hot, humid night, and the car started to stutter. To start off with, we thought it was fuel related. We actually gave Tom a call and said, where's the nearest petrol station, or can you come down with a jerry can to top her up and give us a bit of a hand, because I don't think the fuel gauge works. Turned out it wasn't the fuel gauge. So what was happening was, it appears that the coil in the humid environment had started to break down and have some issues electrically inside. That had then impacted the CDI and had actually damaged the CDI. We did some searching online, read a number of articles, and discovered the classic retrofit CDI, and purchased one of those very quickly and got it shipped over with a new coil as well. So we eliminated those parts of the system that were having issues. Car was literally a couple of minutes away from coming out of the garage and being back on the road, and we sprang a fuel leak from the front fuel pump. So the 930 has two, one at the front, one at the rear, and we sprang a leak from the front one. Only the smallest of leaks. However, from a safety perspective, you don't want to be driving a car around with a fuel leak, but also the car had started to not start again and had failed to turn over, either because the fuel pressure had dropped just below the required pressure, or just the whole internal of the pump had failed. So then we had to wait for another 10 days for the new fuel pump to arrive. So we do have a bit of paper for the next issues that we've got here. So there were some issues with the oil gauge, not only with the gauge but the sensor as well in the oil tank. So both of those had to be replaced. It was open circuit, so it was always reading that oil was full and maximum. So we got those replaced and installed. The other part of the issue that we were having with the car, and I think this is fundamentally because the car seems to have sat for quite some time. So although the car had been looked after and serviced particularly well by the previous owner, it had sat for a while. So the first issues that we're having associated with that were that we were starting to get one of the pistons on the passenger side was starting to get sticky. So if you let go of the steering wheel after you press the brakes, it will pull to one side. So we had a refurbishment of the pistons on the front brakes only, and I will come back to that a little bit later. And that work was done, and that stopped the stickiness in the pistons. So year one of ownership of the 930 had gone relatively well. Yes, we'd had some costs, nothing that kind of wasn't expected from a car that had sat for a little while and from a classic Porsche. I think you've always got to be prepared to put your hand in your pocket a little bit for these older cars, but nothing too drastic. Issues were mainly around being able to get spares, get them shipped in and get parts here. The spares and the parts were not significant issues to the running of the car. So, like we said, here's the price for the first year of ownership of the car. However, for dollars associated with smiles and our enjoyment of the car, chuffed to bits, couldn't be any happier. So there were some elements of the car that when we got it and it went through our initial inspection that we knew we would have problems with the car. The first one and predominant one was the suspension. So the struts had small telltale leaks on them, so they would need replacing. In all honesty, we kind of cleaned them up, got it through a registration to start off with, and thought we'd fix those up at a later time. We were unsure at the time if we would go with the original Bilsteins or if we would go with coilovers or what we would kind of do. So the plan was just to get a through registration to start off with and then fix up some of those issues a little bit later. So as you will see in prices coming up, we could have fixed those in the first year. However, we did put them off for a little while knowing that we'd be able to get away with it for a bit. The sloppiness of the car wouldn't be ideal, but we were keen to kind of enjoy it, get the most out of it, and then do some additional work on it a little bit later. So, as we go through the paperwork of owning and trying to run a classic Porsche, let me try and sort out some of this and put some of this away. Next issues we had with her were the alternator. We were coming back from a trip from Hatter. Clear indication from the car that we're having battery or alternator problems are that the tacho starts to wave significantly. We were stuck in traffic at the time. It was a warm day. The turbos don't like to sit in Dubai heat, in traffic. They do start to get a little bit warm, so we pulled off to the side of the road. At the time, I wasn't really aware that the indication of the tacho was that the alternator was failing. Pulled over to the side of the road, turned her off to keep her cool and let her cool down for a little while. We went off and got a carrot tea and a coffee. Came back to her and she wouldn't start because the battery was flat again and the alternator was having problems. Big issues trying to get an alternator here in Dubai, so we had to ship one over and get that fitted. That automatically resolved those problems. Getting a new one was really difficult, a new alternator, so we actually got a refurbished Bosch alternator. So as we talked about earlier, we'd had some issues with the front calipers sticking and having some issues with the brakes. We'd had a couple of track days with the 930 and thoroughly enjoyed it out on track. And it probably seems to be that the work that was done on the front brakes wasn't to the standard and quality that it perhaps should have been. And the rear brakes, because we hadn't done any work on those, and they'd probably not been worked on for a little while, started to experience some issues from us driving the car pretty hard and having some fun in it. So we would regularly drive along and get kind of a, I think you'd call it more of an asbestos brake kind of smell, particularly from the rear driver's side. That was starting to smell as we were driving along. So instead of messing around this time like we did the first time, because I think probably the first time we were just too eager to get the car out on the road, having purchased it, waited for it to arrive and gone through all of that experience,
This time we were like, no, we've got to get it fixed properly. So instead of messing around, we went around and did a full brake refurbishment all the way around the car. Got a full kit from Porsche. We even powder coated the calipers so they all look brand new. And give it a whole brake refurbishment. This was like having a new brake kit on the car. So these bills don't normally come in small numbers, and our next one is no exception to that rule. So I will just break this little bit of paper here so that we can kind of go through some of the process here. So this next set of work that we had performed on the 930 was we were addressing the issue that we had with the shocks. As we talked about earlier, we were unsure if to go with the original Bilsteins or go with coilovers. At the time, with wanting to keep the car somewhat original, and because of the price, in all honesty, the price of the coilovers was shocking at the time, and knowing that there was a lot more work to do on the car, we decided to go with the Bilsteins and go with the original shocks. I'm not sure if we will stick with those moving into the future. I think once we've got over a couple of the more recent bills from the 930, then we may look at doing the torsion bar, tightening her up a little bit before we do the coilovers. But having seen them and experienced how they feel on other cars, I think it would be something that we'd very much enjoy to do on the 930. So I think we'll look at that moving into the future. What I would also like to cover there is that we've had a few oil leaks on the 930 over a period of time. Not too much of a surprise on an air-cooled Porsche that you get a number of oil leaks. The ones that we were having were on the timing change case. They hadn't really worried us because they only tend to leak under high pressure. Majority of the time when we were driving the car, it was either up to Jebel Jais or around the area, so that wasn't too bad. When we were out on track, we always kept a close eye on the oil. Topped her up before, did a couple of laps, checked her again, and then went out and gave her full bore, and then gave her a good check over before we drove home as well. So no real issues associated with that. We had had a couple of other minor oil leaks that came from little different spots in the engine, but nothing serious. And to be fair, she never left a stain on the ground. Weren't too many issues, but obviously at some point these would need to be addressed, which we will come to shortly. The other thing that is particularly interesting about this old 930 is that it must have led a very interesting life at some point, because it used to have a boost controller in it. So what we knew was that it had a K27 turbo in it. What we've recently found out from some additional work that we've had on the car is that it also has 964 cams in it. So the boost is set to 1 PSI. Normally on a 930 it's set to 0.8. And I suspect that this at some point was a controller for the boost, and that this car had previously had a fun and exciting life either on track or just bombing around, or just someone modifying it and seeing what they could do with it. In all honesty, I think people may have frowned upon this kind of thing when they were purchasing a car, but for us it seems like it's had a good life and it's enjoyed itself, and it'll enjoy itself long after we've had the car and been here as well. So good on it. It seems like it had had a good time at some point. But we did remove this. It had been kind of semi-removed at some point by somebody, but we just removed the rest of the gump so that it wasn't hanging around the car. So we do like to keep bits from the 930 and any Porsches that and cars that we've got. The garage back in Australia is just covered in rubbish all over the place from bits we've kind of collected. Wayne might say that that's some of the old rusty cars that we've got, but we've got a plethora of stuff everywhere. So we still have the spark plugs that Jonas took out the car. I think as we can see, I'm hoping that comes into focus. They are very worn and they've seen better days. We've also got the injectors as well. I don't think we'll be able to see here. But they just, let's see if that focuses in. They also look like they've seen better days as well. So being a little bit geeky about this, is I find it always fascinating to keep these little extra bits so you got some kind of history of the car. But yeah, clearly once all this had kind of been replaced, the car just ran fantastically. So the latest invoice is on our iPad. We've not had a chance to print this out yet. We were around at Len's place, looked under the car just as we were going to head off home, and there was a drop of oil underneath the car. I politely asked Len if that was from his Beetle, and he kind of pointed out that it was a fresh drop of oil, so it was from the Porsche. So to fix the oil leak, there was removing the engine in the gearbox. We had to remove both of the camshafts and renew the gaskets and the seals, reset the cam timing, and I will come back to that just in a moment, fit back all the parts, and then obviously put the engine back in the car. Strangely for Porsche, it was actually cheaper to buy the full set of gaskets rather than just purchase the gaskets that were required for the job. The main issue was that it was the rear cam housing which was leaking, and that was leaking badly. Even with the car just sat there idling, it was dropping down. There was no way on earth that we should be driving that car, so we must have just caught it right at the point where the seal had gone dry, cracked, and then leaked. We must have just caught it at the ideal moment, because what we didn't want to do was catch that on a long drive and then be really stuck, because that could have really caused some significant issues. As Jonas opened up the engine, that was where we discovered that we had the 964 cams. So that with the K27 turbo seems to be an upgrade on the 930. Well, we hope you enjoyed the video. It is the first time that we've put the prices down for owning a car for the first and second year. To be honest, the second year was a little bit of a surprise on how much that cost. The first year was pretty reasonable, about $4,432. The second year, by the time you kind of add it all up, seems to have got a little bit out of control at $14,770. So we put that in US dollars because the figure looks significantly smaller than if it was Australian dollars, and it looks significantly smaller again than comparing it to the United Arab Emirates currency. So that does make us feel somewhat slightly better. We have had some work done on the car that we didn't cover in the video. So we've changed the front and rear fuse holders to the classic retrofit units. We changed the compressor on the air conditioning unit, and we also replaced the dryer at the front of the car so that the air conditioner ran a little bit better. We've covered that in the costs, but we just didn't cover those aspects in the video. I think we've been very honest and transparent about the costs that we've had for the car over the first 2 years. We are hoping the third year is significantly cheaper. At this stage, we're looking at an oil change, oil filter change, and then we'll probably have to change the rear and potentially the front tires on the car, because they've aged a little bit. And to be fair, the rear tires have had a number of punches. And if we're going to take her out on track again, then we need to make sure that the tires are going to hold up. So hopefully, moving forwards, fingers crossed, they're the only cost that we'll have with her moving forwards. If you've got any questions about classic Volkswagens, classic Porsches, cost of ownership, any questions that you've got, please put them in the comments below and we'll get to them as soon as we can.
like we said, hope you enjoyed the video, guys. Please like, subscribe, and we'll catch you again with a new video soon. See you later, guys.